Hey, I finally found you. This is very important.
Detective, I've heard you're searching for artifacts that affect human minds. I believe I may have a very powerful one. Come to 13 Bleary Street ASAP. The city is in danger.
So glad you came. The police won't listen to me. I'm Ethan. Wait, I'll open it and explain. No, not again. Forgive me. I can't control it. Please, find something to bind me. Hurry! This net won't hold me for long. The Dreamcatcher makes me stronger and more aggressive. But if you make me a special sedative, it will keep me calm. Thank you. Now I can explain everything. Since childhood, I've been having exhausting nightmares. Nothing helped. Until recently, when I saw an ad in the newspaper. Naila Moore, the famous psychotherapist, was in town and holding free therapy sessions. I'm in debt, so I gladly paid her a visit. That's when she gave me the Dreamcatcher. But now my condition is even worse. I have daily nightmares, I experience constant rage, and there's this strange mark on my hand. I've called Naila, but got no response. Please, examine this thing. shattering. What is this? Help! I can't hold on!
In a small village, there once lived a romantic girl named Doris Jackson. She was the only daughter of a rich farmer, betrothed to marry the miller's son, whom she did not love. One day, a rich traveler drove by and fell in love with Doris at first sight. He gave her flowers and proposed to her. Doris, who hated, she ran away that night, leaving only a letter behind. A black cat ran between the two village families. Time passed, and her story was forgotten.
This creature chained me here! I can't move! Thank you.
young couple celebrated their wedding. Doris was rolling in wealth, but a storm was brewing. A year later, Doris gave birth to a son, but her husband was more interested in wine and parties. He rarely stayed at home, as Doris couldn't bear her child to grow up in such a poisoned atmosphere. She returned to her parents' empty nest and begged them to care for him. They agreed. Jacksons forbid their grandson to play with other children. His only friend was a tattered scarecrow near the farm. Meanwhile, Doris was secretly watching over her son. One day, Doris found the courage to speak to her son. She dressed herself in the scarecrow's clothes and told him she had come to life. They often played in the fields together. Until one day, when the village boys started a fire in the fields, Doris and the boy ran until they reached a cliff. The earth suddenly gave way, and Doris...
I'll go to the mill and put an end to this. That scarecrow must vanish.
My son, please forgive me. I just wanted to be with you and watch you grow.
I was such a fool. I can't believe you were here all along.
Take this to the real world. Give Ethan my letters.
Give me the Dreamcatcher, and no one gets hurt. I'm sorry, but I have no choice.